So if you've ever sold a house or thought about selling a house or being in the real estate business, you know one of the biggest expenses that we have to incur in this game is transaction fees. And inside of the transaction fees, it's going to be real estate agent fees. Those are the biggest fees we gotta pay. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how I've been able to save 3% on every transaction for the last, 10 years, simply by doing exactly what I'm going to teach you in this video right here. Let's get to it. Okay, class, it's Kris Haskins with therealestateroundup.com. My mission and ministry is to raise your financial literacy through real estate investing and entrepreneurship. So since doing real estate from 2004, the good thing about it is I've been able to hang around some unbelievable people. I've been able to go through the good, the bad, ups and downs, pretty much every type of market that you've seen. And we can boil it all down and bring these videos to you to help you to prevent you from having to go through all the mess that I went through. So today we're going to go over to show you, but because if you're flipping houses or you're in the business and you're selling real estate, you know that these transaction fees can eat you alive. And one of the main secrets and skills that you have to learn for longevity in this business is controlling fees, controlling expenses. Now, there's a whole ton of expenses, taxes, insurance, inspectors, cost of the money, all this stuff. But today, we're just going to deal with real estate agent fees. So what are we talking about here? We're talking about dealing with a flat fee broker. And I don't know, you might have some thoughts about that stuff, but I want to explain to you why this is so important. So how does it generally work when you sell a piece of real estate? Well, usually you have a 6% real estate agent fee or realtor fee. Yes, realtor, it's not realtor. Oh God, where's my people when I need them? Realtor, there's no A in that, realtor, okay? So how is that broken down? Well, it's 3% that goes to the buyer's agent. That is the real estate agent that brings the buyer to buy the property. And then 3% that goes to the selling real estate agent. That's usually the person that the agent that we list the property through. And I know you might be watching this and saying, oh, Kris, I'm just going to do it for sale by owner. I ain't even going to deal with none of them fools. I promise you, if you're going to stay in this business for any amount of time, doing it for sale by owner ain't going to work. Just doesn't work. It's not enough traffic on the property. And some people, frankly, just will not buy a property unless it's listed with a real estate agent. So just wipe that out of your mind. For sale by owners, for investors, ain't going to work. All right. So how is this 3% broken down? Well, generally, it's going to be 1% goes to the broker, and the other 1.5%, and then the other 1.5% goes to the real estate agent. You see, the real estate agent has to be signed up with a broker so they can hang their license. So it's really not a lot of money going around when you boil it down. All right, so that's why we're looking. So if you deal with a broker, directly with the broker, they get the whole 3%. So you see here that the broker will get the 3% because they don't have to split it with the real estate agent. So, well, Kris, what does that look like? Well, usually you get 6% and the seller pays the whole 6%. So that's $6,000 on every $100,000, $12,000 on $200,000, and $24,000 on $300,000, and so on and so forth. It can really add up. I've seen some real estate agents actually, and I've done deals where the real estate agent makes more money than me. It's sick. I will never forget one time I had to walk in and bring $1,500, and I'm looking at the HUD like, good God, the real estate agent making $12,000. I'm bringing money to do the deal. So we have to learn how to control these costs. How do we do that? Something called a flat fee broker, right? A flat fee. I remember hearing about this from my boy Don DeRosa. What's up, Don, if you're watching? He's down in Atlanta. I went to a seminar, paid a bunch of money to go. He says, I'm gonna talk to you about flat fee brokers. At the time, I'm like, no, I ain't doing that. I just pay the whole 6%. Once I started doing 10 houses, 20 houses, 30 houses, looking back at all the expenses I was paying, I'm like, you know what? Maybe I need to really take a look at doing this. All right, so what is a flat fee broker? Well, let's get to our Barron's book. If you don't have your Barron's real estate guide, it's gonna be in the video description. You got to have your Barron's just for definitions. All right, the flat fee broker is a licensed broker who charges a fixed fee for provisions of brokerage services instead of commissions based on a percentage of the sales price of the property. So instead of charging a commission, they're just charging a flat set fee. Okay. Now, I need to show you how to locate these people, because a lot of you are thinking, well, Kris, I don't know a broker that's going to do this. Or a lot of brokers won't do it. And then some agents are like, man, I'm definitely doing that. They have no idea how this works. So listen, if I'm pouring into you, make sure you subscribe, hit that button below, and hit the bell so you know when we're coming on live and doing different trainings. So now that you know what it is, how do we find these people? And where are they hiding? Well, I'm going to go over this here. I'm going to bring them on the screen, show you. First, I need you to see what not to look for, because you're gonna go through more people that will not do this as opposed to people that will, okay? So in order to locate these brokers that are going to do this, then I'm going to kind of tell you how it works. You have to pull a list from the MLS. Just get a real estate agent to give you all the sales for the past 6 months, or for the past 3 months. Have them email it to you. That way you can scroll through there, and you have to make sure that they put down the agent remarks. They got to have agent remarks in the bottom so you know what the broker's mindset is and what the broker will or will not do. But so let me show you, I pull some things here from my local MLS. That's the multiple listing systems where all the agents put the houses, put the properties in. So I'm gonna show you what not to look for. So on the agent remarks, you'll see down at the bottom, it says blah, 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 all that stuff. But you notice here, it says the home is vacant on Rain lockbox, call or text agent. That's not what we're looking for. Wherever your listing says deal with the real estate agent, that's not going to work, because we know the agent is in the middle there. All right, here's another one where it says at the beginning, all offers must be submitted by the buyer's agent. Okay, that means the real estate agent for the buyer is still involved. Okay, so they want to get paid. Now, this is what we're actually looking for. All right, so the remarks here say, enter at your own risk, structurally unsound. Agents, please deal directly with owner to negotiate contract and to check availability. All right, you see, notice here, the buyer's agent says, don't call me. I ain't gonna take no phone calls. Don't even call me, call the seller directly. That's what we're looking for. Somebody that doesn't want to take phone calls and doesn't even want to answer any questions, okay? This is another one here. Call owner for showings and questions at blank. All right, so that is the remarks. This is how you locate these people. So once again, you pull a list from the MLS, maybe the last 6 months, try to get cash offers if you can, but your real estate agent is gonna be able to send you these listings to see, so you can do a search and see who's doing flat fee stuff. And that's the language that you're looking for. And by the way, I got these handouts here. There's a link in the video description if you want to download my handouts so you can see what it actually looks like in person. You don't have to guess. You could just say, okay, boom. All right, that link's in the video description too. So here's the biggest thing. How does it work once you've located these flat fee real estate brokers? Right? Because agents usually won't be able to do this because they have to split the fee with the broker. All right. How does it work? You are going to have to do all the work, everything. So what I learned is, when a real estate agent lists a house for sale, generally speaking, who does all the work? The internet. They put the property up on the internet, and then the buyers go through. They look around. They say, I like 123 Easy Street. I like 456 Brown Street. I like all these houses, and then the buyer's agent goes and takes them around. So I can't prevent you from paying the buyer's agent, because the buyer's agent is going to be the one out there doing all the work. But what we can do is slash away the selling agent. But usually you got to pay an agent to bring a buyer. So what we're doing is we're getting rid of the selling agent. That's the person that we're listing the property with. So the selling agent is our agent. They put it on the MLS. They sit back, buyers come, they do a contract, boom, they negotiate, whatever, okay? So it's not necessarily a lot of work. No disrespect to my real estate agents that are watching, because I know this is how you feed your family. But why would a broker do a flat fee listing when they can get 3% from dealing with the seller on these deals? Well, first of all, it's volume. Let's say this, out of a ballpark number, you're paying $1,000 flat fee. You gotta think about that broker's mindset. So I'm getting $1,000, I don't have to do anything. All I'm doing is putting the property on the MLS, that's it. The owner's going to negotiate the contract. The owner's going to deal with the inspector. The owner's going to deal with the appraiser, the seller, the agent, all that stuff. And all I have to do is boom, put it on there. It's almost like sending an email and I'm done. That can be attractive to a broker, a busy broker. Okay, so I don't know what fee you're going to be able to negotiate, but usually when a broker has a flat fee, they already know how much they're going to charge. Could be $500, could be $1,000, depending on what your market is. Could be $1,500, could be $2,000. I don't know. You know, if you're in LA, New York, Miami, it's going to be a little bit higher. So the mindset of the broker is, I want to list this property on the MLS and do nothing else. So you are going to have to do all the stuff I just talked about. That's how it works. Okay, so if you're new to this business, it might not be the best thing for you. So the broker is looking for volume. You might do 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 houses in a year, which they're going to make their money on the volume. That's why they're willing to chop their commission off. And further, the broker doesn't do anything. So you're going to have to get your skills up. All right, I never forget, I've referred some flat fee brokers in my area to some people, and they screw it up. You can't put work back on the broker when you're not paying them the full 3% commission. You have to take on all the work. And yes, that includes showing the property. The broker doesn't want to get any phone calls. So how it works is you have to deal with all the interaction, the interfacing with the buyer's agents and all their technicians and professionals and inspectors that are going to come, lenders and all that stuff. And then when it's time to ratify the contract, that's when the broker just signs off and it's over. So you're taking all the work. And the biggest part is accepting all the different offers and showing the property, okay? So it's not like you could say, call my agent, they take care of this, call my broker. No. All this work falls back on you, okay? But the good thing about it is you're saving 3% on the seller side, okay? So I hope this video has helped you understand why the broker would do that. Why on earth would anybody even sign up to do a flat fee? And further, how do you find them, what they're looking for, and how do you define what this stuff is? What I've learned is controlling, I can't tell you, I don't know how many hundreds of thousands of dollars I've saved in selling 3%, right? That's crazy. And I want you to do the same. And don't let these transaction fees hold you back from getting in the real estate business, all right? Subscribe to the channel, like this content if it's helped you at all, and share with other people that are trying to make it in this business. I want to do this business, but I'm just nervous. You got realtors, you got agents, you got all this stuff going around in your head. It can be a lot. That's why we've made these videos, to make your journey a little easier, okay? Share it around. Kris Haskins over and out. I'll see you on the next video. Peace.